everyone, welcome to English Kaksha. Today we will start English literature of 12th class and I'm going to take the very first poem of 12th class, My Mother at 66. The explanation of the poem is given in a very simple way that will make you understand this poem very easily. After that, the literary devices are also explained. So watch the video very carefully. Let's start your flamingo book. I'm going to take your very first poem, My Mother at 66. It is very beautiful poem composed by Kamala Das. Before we read the poem, we will read about the poet. Kamala Das is a well-recognized Indian poet. Recognized means popular. She is well known for her versatility and originality of her work. Versatility means different work. She always shows indigenous flavor or soil in her writing. Indigenous means native. In this poem, she brings out a common paradox of human relationship. Now we will read the poem, stanza 1. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me, dozed, open mouth, her face ashen like that of a corpse, and realized with pain that she was old as she looked. What is given in this stanza? Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday morning. Here, the poetess recalls the day when she was driving from her parents' home to Cochin. And it was Friday morning, right? She was going there to catch a flight. I saw my mother, it means the poetess, saw her mother was sitting next to her. Her mouth was open and she was trying to sleep for a short time. When she looked at her mother's face, she noticed that her face was looking like a corpse. Corpse means dead body of a human. Her face was looking like of a dead body. Because it was, why it was looking like a dead body? Because she was growing too old and she was feeling very weak. And realized with pain that she was old as she looked. At that time, a painful thought came into the poetess' mind and she realized with pain that her mother had become very old and would not live for long. Second stanza. But soon put that thought away and looked out at young trees sprinting. Young trees sprinting. The merry children spilling out of their homes, but after the airport security check, standing a few yards away. But soon put that thought away. Here the poetess is saying that she soon drove away from her mind the thought of her mother's pale and aged face. Put that thought away means turned her mind away from that thought and looked at young trees sprinting. Young trees sprinting means running very fast. And merry children, merry means happy children, spilling out of their homes. Spilling means coming out of their homes. But after the security check, standing a few yards away. Now let me tell you what is given in this stanza. Here the poetess is saying that soon she drove away from her mind the thought of her mother's pale and aged face. She started looking out at the young trees that seemed to be running fast. She looked at the children running out of their houses in joy. At last they reached at the airport security check and there she again looked at her mother. It was to be noticed that the poetess had not spoken a single word to her mother throughout the drive. And even now she just looks at her mother from a distance. Perhaps it is a sad reflection of how indifferent the modern youth have grown towards their aged elders. Stanza 3. I looked at her when pale as a late winter's moon and felt that old familiar ache. My childhood fear. But all I said was, see you soon, Amma. All I did was smile and smile and smile. What she is saying here? I looked at her. I means the poetess looked at her mother again. What she noticed means after the security check, the poetess looked at her mother who was standing a few yards away outside. The mother looked very pale and weak. Her face looked pale and white, like the face of
अ लेट विंटर्स मून, जैसे चांद सर्दियों में चांद जो बड़ा डिम सा नजर आता है ना, इसी तरह से उसकी मदर का चेहरा भी बड़ा डिम लग रहा था, राइट? सो दैट्स वाई इट इज गिविंग अ सिमिलैरिटी ऑफ मून विद द फेस ऑफ द मदर, सो इट इज सिमिली. ऑल द फेमिलियर एक मीन्स द नेगिंग फियर दैट शी वॉज फीलिंग फ्रॉम हर चाइल्डहुड. वट वॉज द फियर? दैट वन डे हर मदर वुड नॉट लिव फॉर लॉन्ग. बट ऑल आई सेड वॉज द ओनली थिंग शी सेड, सी यू सून अम्मा. एंड ऑल आई डिड वॉज स्माइल एंड स्माइल एंड स्माइल. ऑल शी डिड वॉज स्माइल एंड स्माइल एंड स्माइल. Actually, in these lines, she wants to convey the idea that the youngers do feel for their elders, but they don't communicate it properly. That's why in the beginning, I told you it is giving a common paradox of human relationship. Now we will see which kind of poetic devices are used in this poem. Let's see here. First, simile is used. Her face ashen-like. Like word is given here. So it is her face ashen-like that of a corpse. Second, as a late winter's moon. Second device is personification. Trees sprinting means trees are running very fast. How can trees run fast? It means they are personified here. That's why it is personification. Third is metaphor. Merry children spilling out of their homes. Next is repetition. Smile, smile and smile. Smile, smile, smile. The one word is repeated again and again. So this is called repetition. Now I hope you have understood this poem very clearly. After this, you can do a variety of exercises from the different books. Thank you.